All right, Winter NAMM 2013 here with Mr. Gary Hoey. How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for making the time.
Thanks. Happy NAMM, everybody.
Yes, this is exciting, isn't it?
It is, absolutely. I'm excited to be back and at the Rocktron GHS booth hanging out and got my new signature pedal called the Intimidator. And very excited about this because I've been wanting to do a signature pedal for a long time with Rocktron, and this is something we've been developing, you know, over the last 6 months. And during my new record, Deja Blues, I got to use this on the album.
Okay.
And, you know, a lot of people say, well, a distortion box is a distortion box. But this one, we tried to make something that was a little bit more over the top so that if people really want to get some good sustain, good gain, and also it covers a lot of range. Like, my new record's a blues record, but this also works if you're playing hard rock and heavy metal. It kind of goes the full extreme. And my settings are like this. I like, what we have is we have bass and treble, we have gain, volume, and this is called punish. If you want to punish it a little bit. I tend to roll the highs off a little because I don't like too much highs. And then I roll up the gain about a little back here, and then the volume's at 12, bass is at 12, and I put a little more punish. And that's my personal settings that I like to use.
And I noticed that the treble rolled off. That obviously complements a blues style very well.
It does. And, you know, I've also done that even with my my other albums that are not so much blues. And I'll tell you why. A lot of guitar players, when they adjust their tone, they're standing up like this, and their speakers are down at their legs. And they don't realize how much high end is kind of blasting out. So what I tend to do is I crouch down, I listen, and I make sure that it's not hurting, you know, your ear. And so I've always tended to roll off the treble a little bit. Even if I walk up to an amp and I adjust it, I'll tend to roll off the highs and bring up the bass. I think it adds a little warmth to the tone because guitar tends to be a mid-range instrument anyway. You know, if you look on a graph, it's generally in the 2K, 2.5 to 4K. So it's a mid-range instrument. So be careful, guys, how much high end you put.
You know, it's funny you say it's a mid-range instrument, and that's one of the problems when, like, people scoop the mids so much. You never hear that through the mix because you're basically taking the entire range of the instrument out of the mix. It sounds cool when you're chugging, but in a live band setting, sometimes you lose that.
You're absolutely right. That's a very good way to put it. There's a lot of young people that want to play the heavy, chuggy riffs, and it's great to write songs like that and record it like that. But, you know, if you want the melody to stick out, if you want, you know, the lead to stick out, and you're wondering why you're not hearing any of it, bring up the mid-range a little bit. You know, find a balance. And I did an album with Roy Thomas Baker, the famous producer, you know, who did Queen and Foreigner, The Cars. You know, not too many big bands, and he really likes.
I never heard of any of those.
I know. He said someday they're going to get famous.
Right.
But he really likes 500 hertz.
Right.
He's a big fan of 500. I never knew how much, like, 500 gives you this cool lower mid kind of, like, thickness.
Right.
And he told me a lot of American producers like 2K and 4K. You know, they like that real bite and sizzle. So some of you guys might want to try playing with 500. Gives it a nice warmth, a nice low mid. But if you go to see a band live, sometimes you'll listen to the guitar play and wonder, like, why you can't hear the guy. I call it the mosquito tone, which is all highs, all lows, and no mids. It sounds like a mosquito.
I've also heard the bees, the buzzing bees, and bees in a jar.
Yep, swarm of bees.
Yeah.
There you go, killer bees.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's, you know, it's important to find the sweet spot.
Yep.
And when you're dialing in your sound, bend down, put your ear in front of the actual speaker so you can hear what's coming out.
You've been playing Rocktron for a long time.
I've been with Rocktron for over 2 decades, probably the longest endorsement, you know, deal I've ever had. We're great friends. I've been playing GHS strings for a very long time now too, many, many years. And it's funny, I grew up in the 70s playing boomers, you know, and then I fell out of it for years. You know, I was kind of bouncing around, and then I came back to GHS, you know, probably more than a decade ago, and have been using GHS, and absolutely, I love them.
I too have been using GHS boomers, 9s or 10s for, Jesus, look like Battle of the Bands in high school. One of the things for me personally, they don't break. I mean, unless you get any real string that's real thin, I mean, they're very, very durable strings.
Well, you know what? It's funny you should say that, because when I used to use some other string companies, and then I went back to Boomer.
Yeah.
And I use 10 through 52.
Yep.
It's called TNT set or something. I use that, and I've been using 10s lately too a little bit. I don't know why, I think I'm getting old. But I went up to Russ, the president of the company. I said, Russ, why do my boomers tend to sound a little thicker?
Right.
Why is it? Why are they a little bit, just something? I don't know what it is. And he said, our core is a little thicker. So he said that the you know, a wound string has a core, has a center piece of metal. And then the string is wrapped, you know, with a coating, with a core metal. So if that core is a little thicker, you're going to notice a slightly little bit of a thicker tone.
Right.
And less breakage of the strings, which you just said. So GHS for me, not just because of the letters, you know, Gary Hoey strings.
Oh, look at that.
No, that's not the main reason I use them.
I think we're unraveling a conspiracy theory.
We're unraveling it like a string. It's unraveling. I told Russ, you know, change the company name to Gary Hoey strings.
There you go.
That did not fly.
Nice. Well, all very exciting stuff. This is exciting. And I do want to point out...
No, you can't have it.
I tried. But all Rocktron pedals have something very specific. Like, this has the Punish. And if you take a look at, like, Rocktron has a lot of pedals, three different series of pedals, and all the pedals have different, very unique settings or options.
Yeah.
And that's one of the things I always like when I cover a Rocktron pedal. So another one, a new and exciting one in the lineup, the Intimidator. And I'm looking forward to, you know, trying that out sometime.
You got to get a chance to check it out. I'll be demoing it the next couple days at the show. But this is the first camo look that they've done. Yeah. I wanted something different. I went for the white knobs, the chicken head type knobs, because I love the silver and all that, but it's hard to see on stage
that's
sometimes.
Right. Yeah.
So I wanted something practical where you can see the controls real quick. And also the gain, this is the gain. So if you're playing live and you can actually kick this with your toe, if you need a little gain, you could actually kind of give it a little something if the other guy's drowning you out.
Yep. Awesome.
So check out the Intimidator. I think you'll dig the sound.
Awesome. Thank you for making the time. Have a great show, and I look forward to the demo later on.
My pleasure. I definitely want to just tell people out there, man, you know, Tone King, keeping you informed, keeping you educated.
All right.
So I want to just tell you guys, keep doing what you're doing, because you guys are doing a fantastic job. Thanks for having me on.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Yeah, God bless
you.
And happy NAMM.
Have a great show.
Walk out! Intimidator!
All right.